me. Not sure if this is going to pick up the sky, but it is a dirty pink kind of colour out there at the moment, which I think is the sunset trying to break through to the east. But the hurricane's changed direction. It's around about 7-ish. The water's receded, but hasn't left pool looking too good. And in the end, I would say minimal flooding damage in the house, but yeah, we're almost there. So tail end of the hurricane, and hopefully it'll be all over in about no more than an hour or so. First time I've been able to step outside all day properly. See, the water's receded right down from where it was, which is cool, but so much fucking damage, it's untrue. It's actually quite chilly now. It's been like really hot all day still, but really humid. So what is it going to look like tomorrow? No electric. I feel sorry for the people over that side, where they're right up where the canal is.
Search and rescue teams from across the country have been deployed as well, and we anticipate they will be in Lee County sometime today and into the early hours tomorrow, and they are prepared to go to work right away. It's important to recall, to remember, that Lee County Governor, along with the Sheriff's Office, executed a curfew, countywide curfew, last night at 6 p.m. That curfew applies to not just unincorporated Lee County, but to all of the cities as well. It started at 6 o'clock last night, and it is in effect until it is changed by local government. All 15 shelters in the county remain open. As of yesterday, near late in the day, there were only still about 4,000 people in those shelters. Given the amount of damage in the community, I think it's reasonable to expect that those shelters will begin to fill up a little more. We have space for about 40,000 people. And so if you need sheltering and you could make you have more comfortable accommodations, then, you know, you can come to these shelters. The emergency management operation, along with other partners, are working to increase water, ice, and food supplies in Lee County. So over the next several days, you'll see more and more of the semi-tractor trailers loaded with water and ice and food showing up in Lee County. And the